Jesus, our shepherd. John chapter 10, verse 11, verse 14, 15, and 27, 28. Jesus said, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd gives his life for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my sheep and am known by my own. As the Father knows me, even so I know the Father, and I lay down my life for the sheep. My sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me. And I give them eternal life, and they shall never perish, neither shall anyone snatch them out of my hand. It's so wonderful to come into the New Testament and see the Lord Jesus revealing his relationship with his people with that same picture of the shepherd to the sheep. And he calls himself, I as the good shepherd. In other places in the New Testament, the Lord is called as the shepherd and overseer of our souls. That's 1 Peter 2:25. In 1 Peter 5:4, he's called the chief shepherd. And in Hebrews 13:20, he's called the great shepherd. So this is who Jesus is. He's the great shepherd of our souls. He's the chief shepherd. He's a shepherd and overseer of our souls. And Jesus said, I am the good shepherd. And all that we saw in Psalm 23, Jesus reaffirms to us. He says, look, I give my very life for my sheep. That means this is how much I love them, how much I care for them. I care so much for my sheep. I give my life for them. I lay my life down for them. He says, I guide my sheep. I lead my sheep. My sheep hear my voice. I know them and they follow me. Jesus knows you. He knows you personally because he says, I know my sheep. And then he says, my sheep hear my voice. That means he's guiding you. He's speaking into your life. He's counseling you. And he says, they follow me. Now you and I have the choice to follow Jesus. And Jesus says, I give them eternal life and no one can take them out of my hand and they will not perish. Just like how David said, I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. This is our good shepherd. He cares for us. Everything we read in Psalm 23, Jesus does for us. So you and I look to Jesus and say, thank you for being the shepherd and the overseer of my life. Thank you for being the one who guides me, who counsels me. Thank you, Lord, for leading me, for causing me to lie down in green pastures, for leading me to those still waters. Thank you that you're the one who anoints my head with oil. You're the one who makes my cup run over. You're the one who spreads his table before me in the presence of my enemies. Jesus, you're the shepherd of my soul. Let's worship him. Let's thank him. And let's acknowledge that he does for us everything we saw in the 23rd Psalm and everything he promised here in John 10. This is he. This is who he is to us. Let's pray. Lord Jesus, we thank you and we worship you as the shepherd of our souls. You are the good shepherd. You will never forsake us. You will never abandon us. You guard us and you guide us. Your rod and your staff, they comfort us. You are the good shepherd. You give your very life for us. You are the one, Lord, who knows us. You're the one who speaks to us. And Lord, we choose to follow you. Thank you for giving us eternal life and keeping us safe in your hand. In Jesus' name.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.